The stories of Colombian author Gustavo Bolivar are not based in fantasy. He prefers to convey the grittier dreams and pitfalls of real life.
When I had the privilege of entering the TV world, which is hard to do as a writer, I decided I wouldn't waste the opportunity on writing Cinderella stories of the poor girl who marries the rich man. I wanted to do something different that would provide a mirror for my society, the truth.
Gustavo
has written 8 books and some 1,600 scripts for telenovelas, docuseries, and films. But what launched him into international fame was his bestseller turned TV series, Without Breasts, There Is No Paradise. It's the story of a young Colombian girl who seeks massive breast implants to attract a rich cocaine smuggler.
This is a difficult job because you are denouncing a social injustice. In the case of Without Breasts, There Is No Paradise, I am denouncing that a generation of girls without opportunities of employment end up in the hands of the mafia because they don't have other opportunities.
Poverty and lack of opportunities for Latin America's youth was also the subject of Gustavo's Pandilla, or Gang series.
Although the popular Colombia series was produced in the 1990s, the issue of gangs is still relevant in Colombia today. Government estimates show there are at least 8,000 gangs operating across the country, counting more than 50,000 members.
Gustavo Bolivar says the core problems he addressed in the series remain just as challenging today.
I think our biggest tragedy is the lack of education. We have a lack of coverage and lack of quality.
Bolivar's series on drug lords, gangs, and those who live in the underworld has gained popularity over the decades. The action and the drama undoubtedly make for good TV. But Bolivar says this can't be confused with a glorification of that lifestyle.
You don't find any of these narco series ending with a drug lord in a yacht with 7 women and a bottle of whiskey. They all end up in jail or extradited and dragging their family and innocent people through great tragedies.
A Colombian writer who shows us time and time again that some of life's greatest tragedies are based on real-world circumstances. Michelle Begues, CGTN, Bogotá.